Veuillez vous asseoir.
The President,
Le président,
please be seated.
Vous asseoir.
The court is now in session.
L'audience est ouverte.
According to our schedule, today hearing.
Aujourd'hui,
we going to hear documents being put before the chamber by the prosecutors.
Que l'accusation produira devant la chambre certains documents.
Without further ado, we would like to hand over to the co-prosecutors.
Nous donnons la parole au bureau des coprocureurs.
Present the documents before the chamber.
Le coprocureur.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Good morning, Your Honours, Council,
Bonjour,
members
Madame,
of the public.
Les juges, maîtres, mesdames et messieurs les membres du public.
As the President just indicated, we will continue our presentation of documents which we consider important for this trial segment,
segment
in particular in relation to the pre-1975 role of Khieu Samphan. And by way of a general roadmap perhaps for today, I might indicate that I will finish in approximately 20 minutes. And then my colleagues
D'ici
will continue
minutes,
with presentation of documents relating more specifically to Yang Sari's role in the pre-1975 period. I indicated yesterday that I only had one more record to present to your honours.
It
is a video,
video.
File. This is found at E109/2.3. It was
2.3.
Proposed as evidence both by us and by the civil party lead co-lawyers.
Et par les co-avocats principaux pour les parties civiles.
The documentary is approximately 90 minutes long. I will only show
5
brief segments which
90
are relevant
je vais
for the purposes of the present discussion.
Qui sont
and by way of background,
pour vous donner des indications
the documentary
de contexte,
was
ce documentaire
by
a été produit par
Swedish company,
une société suédoise, le réalisateur est David Aronowicz, ainsi que Stefan Lindberg. D'après le résumé, il est indiqué que la préparation du documentaire a duré un an et demi. Pendant ce temps-là, les auteurs et producteurs ont suivi Khieu Samphan, et cela se retrouve dans les images.
Latter part of the footage actually
dans
follow
la dernière partie,
arrest and include some
on
footage
suit l'arrestation de Khieu Samphan et il y a certaines images
without further
de la procédure.
Ado, I will
sans plus
now
attendre.
Go to the first segment and
je
just before we play that segment,
avant
I'll just indicate
passer,
two matters.
Je voudrais
first,
attirer votre attention sur
interpretation
deux
will be provided.
L'interprétation
so if all
sera
participants
fournie,
simply stay on their channels,
si vous restez sur votre canal de prédilection, vous allez
entendre
l'interprétation dans votre langue en fonction de l'original. Deuxièmement, parmi ces images, on entend la voix du réalisateur. Notre intention n'est pas de présenter cette voix off.
Because we didn't want to cut
elle se trouve là parce que nous ne voulions pas supprimer les segments où on entend cette voix off du réalisateur pour ne pas interrompre
so,
la continuité dans les déclarations
note,
de l'accusé lui-même.
Là-dessus, segment number one.
Je vais passer
it is
au segment numéro 1 qui dure environ 1 minute et 50 secondes.
Long. It deals primarily with
ce segment
Khieu Samphan's background
as a politician before 1975, de Khieu Samphan avant 1975, et on y voit des images d'époque de Khieu Samphan tournées en 1974. Peut-on faire passer l'extrait numéro 1, s'il vous plaît?
T The Khmer Rouge was a very secret organization. Their top leader, Pol Pot, was unknown to the world. He wanted to rule in the background and needed a public face, someone the people and the world could trust, Khieu Samphan. In the Swedish television archives, we find film footage where Khieu Samphan is introduced as the leader of the Khmer Rouge.
Här kommer de nya kambodjanska ledarna. Det är de som lett och genomfört gerillan in i Kambodja. Först kommer Khieu Samphan, gerillans starke man, och bakom honom Ieng Sary, gerillans ideolog. För Khieu Samphan och det här besöket i Hanoi, hans första visit utanför Kambodja sen kampen började, ryktet gick om att han skulle vara död och det här skulle vara en dubbelgångare. Men det var den riktige Khieu Samphan som hälsade på den diplomatiska kåren i Hanoi. Och det är värt att notera.
Through his reputation and charisma, Khieu Samphan gave the revolution in Cambodia a more human face. But behind his smile, 1.7 million died of famine, executions and torture. Did Khieu Samphan let himself be entirely controlled by Pol Pot? Or was his role more important than he wants to admit to the world?
And that concludes segment number one. I'll just note that color footage was from a visit to Hanoi in 1974. I dealt yesterday with another document which reported that visit or the trip of Khieu Samphan and Ieng Sary in 1974,
which,
again, according to the case file, included the countries of China, Vietnam, North Korea, Albania, and a number of African countries.
Vietnam du Nord.
The next segment is a little bit longer. It's 3 minutes and 55 seconds. Again, we didn't cut it because there are a number of parts where Khieu Samphan is speaking about his early life. And there is some voiceover, but we keep the segment as one because contextually I think it only makes sense if you view the whole portion. If we could have segment number two, please.
Peut-on faire passer ce segment?
The president.
À Paris, quand est-ce que vous avez fait connaissance avec les étudiants cambodgiens plus radicaux?
Ils m'ont souvenu, m'accompagné de Dorly pour aller à Paris. Ce sont les étudiants radicaux qui étaient venus me voir.
Dans ce groupe, il y avait Pol Pot et Ieng Sary ou...
Non, Pol Pot, il était déjà rentré. Je ne l'ai pas rencontré à Paris. Effectivement, Ieng Sary présidait des réunions du CERF marxiste. Dans le temps, on était camarades. Tout le monde. Des Africains, des non-Africains. Des Malgaches, des Marocains, Tunisiens, on était des camarades, des copains. Alors c'est vraiment l'atmosphère de fraternité internationale. Si tous les gars du monde, voyez, c'était la lutte contre le colonialisme. Les étudiants voulaient l'indépendance. Mon ambition, c'est de rentrer au Cambodge et de pouvoir faire quelque chose d'utile pour mon pays.
When Khieu Samphan returns to Cambodia, he has a PhD in economics. In his thesis, he argued that Cambodia must be self-supporting and free from foreign influence. His ideas became important for the Cambodian communists. But back then, he wanted to change his country with politics in a non-violent way. Prince Sihanouk rules in Cambodia. Sihanouk unexpectedly chooses Khieu Samphan as one of his ministers. But Khieu Samphan is too radical. When the security service tries to arrest him, he escapes to the communist rebels in the jungle, the Khmer Rouge.
Je quitte Phnom Penh tout simplement pour sauver ma vie. Tout simplement me placer sous la protection, sous leur protection. Je voyais que eux aussi ils luttaient pour le même but, plus de justice sociale, plus d'indépendance pour le pays. Mais pour eux, ça ne pourrait pas s'obtenir sans la violence.
Sihanouk is overthrown in a coup d'état by General Lon Nol, who is supported by the U.S.
À quel moment j'accepte l'utilisation de la violence pour le changement de la société? Du moment que les États-Unis d'Amérique utilisent Lon Nol pour occuper notre pays, pour utiliser notre pays comme pion dans leur stratégie de la guerre du Vietnam, mais il faut bien résister.
We had to resist. Your Honours, that concludes the second segment, and it just occurs to me it might be helpful if I indicate the starting times of these segments. The second segment starts at 13 minutes and 47 seconds. 13 minutes and 47 seconds. And the first segment, the preceding segment, started at 8 minutes and 6 seconds. The next segment starts at 19 minutes and 15 seconds. It is a 2 minute and 45 second segment. It deals with the U.S. bombings of Cambodia and the unification, if you like, of the forces of the then Prince Norodom Sihanouk and the Khmer Rouge, as well as Khieu Samphan's role in that process. If we could play segment number three now,
please. Je demande à ce que l'on passe le troisième extrait.
The U.S. bombings make the Khmer Rouge more popular.
Ont rendu les Khmer Rouge plus populaires.
More people join
davantage
to overthrow the U.S. supported government.
Pour renverser le gouvernement
à ce moment-là, il y avait deux forces. Voilà. Premièrement, le prince Sihanouk, avec son autorité à l'intérieur du pays et sur la scène internationale, mais qui n'a pas d'armée. Deuxièmement, la force des Khmer Rouge.
The Khmer Rouge forces.
La seule force capable vraiment de mener une résistance Khmer à l'intérieur du pays.
Cambodian resistance.
Mais comment faire
inside the country, but
pour
how could you
rassembler les deux forces?
Bring the two forces together.
Il faut trouver quelqu'un pour servir de trait d'union. Ce quelqu'un-là, c'est moi.
To unite them. And that
et pourquoi moi? Parce que j'étais le seul à être reconnu par le prince de temps en temps, par ma probité, mon intégrité. Et j'étais choisi par le peuple pour faire cette réunion-là.
Sihanouk to leave his exile and come to a meeting in the Cambodian jungle. He succeeds in getting the prince to support the Khmer Rouge.
Le prince soutienne les Khmer Rouge.
Sihanouk's support gives the movement legitimacy in Cambodia and abroad.
Au Cambodge et à l'étranger.
Pol Pot is at the meeting, but in the background.
Pol Pot est à la réunion,
and he does not reveal to Prince Sihanouk who
et
he really is.
Il ne révèle pas sa vraie identité au prince Sihanouk.
In 1974, Khieu Samphan goes to Beijing with Sihanouk Metsing. Khieu Samphan is received as a great leader.
Il y est reçu comme un grand dirigeant.
He has now fully assumed the role as the top leader of the Khmer Rouge.
Le rôle de dirigeant suprême des Khmer Rouges.
Pol Pot acts in the background.
Pol Pot agit en arrière-plan.
This play will go on for 25 years.
Ce jeu va se poursuivre durant 25 ans, tant que les Khmer Rouges
existeront.
Le gouvernement uni cambodgien vient de remporter une des batailles les plus dures de notre époque. Notre victoire, c'est la stratégie pour le Cambodge et le peuple cambodgien.
Armed with weapons.
Thank you. That was the third segment.
Le coproducteur, merci. C'était le troisième extrait.
The next, the remaining two segments, which I will play,
deux extraits.
Deal more closely with the relationship between Khieu Samphan and Pol Pot. And we present these two segments because both one of the themes which we've been discussing yesterday and today is what in our submission is was a close and continuing relationship
of men qui existait à notre avis
and women in the leadership of the CPK, including Khieu Samphan. If we could play the fourth segment, I'll just indicate this is at 23 minutes and 25 seconds
of the documentary.
It is only 1 minute and 8 seconds long.
And
if we could now play that fourth segment, please.
Ce quatrième extrait.
Je suis le triangle entre le prince et les Khmer
Rouges.
Pol Pot connaît que c'est un vrai dirigeant qui analysait bien la situation.
Was a leader who knew.
Moi, je
well
le respecte.
The situation.
Je ne peux pas, pour sauver ma peau, cracher sur la tombe de Pol Pot.
I can't spit on Pol Pot.
Je dis ce que j'ai vu
skin, I will say,
et je dis ce que je pense.
And what I
je le dirai devant le tribunal.
I will say it before the court.
Je tiens à dire que Pol Pot
I have to say,
était un patriote.
That Pol Pot was a patriot.
Il avait essayé de sortir le pays de la pauvreté.
To pull his country.
Il avait espéré faire sortir le pays de la pauvreté par sa politique ultra radicale.
Poverty with his ultra politics.
Il a échoué.
But he failed.
Maintenant, c'est fini.
Now it's over.
That was the fourth segment, and the fifth and final segment starts
at
41 minutes and 28 seconds of this documentary. It is 2 minutes and 57 seconds long, and as I indicated, it continues on this theme of a close relationship between Khieu Samphan and Pol Pot, which of course we have submitted goes back well
d'après nous,
before 1975.
If
we could play segment number 5, please.
Peut-on passer l'extrait numéro 5?
Quand il vient travailler à Pailin,
when he came
c'est ici
to work in Pailin, he stayed here.
Je le suis tout le temps comme une ombre.
I followed him all the time, like a shadow.
Qu'est-ce qu'il a dit pendant ces réunions?
What did he say during these meetings?
Situation politique.
He talked
présente.
About the current
puis,
situation.
Conscience patriotique.
And about patriotic awareness.
Lié à la conscience de classe.
In combination with the awareness
de
of
parti.
The class society. The party.
Sacrifice.
Heroism. Heroism.
Il demande à tous les cadres de
he demanded of all the
se faire
that
de penser, de vivre
and
comme des paysans.
Like peasants.
En moi,
and I
j'ai fait mes efforts, mais je ne peux pas.
I did my best, but I.
Et puis le problème de. De la contradiction marxiste.
Then there were the problems with the Marxist.
Tout se tient, tout change.
Everything is still, yet everything changes.
La partie est le tout.
The party is everything.
Est-ce que vous raisonnez comme ça maintenant, actuellement?
Do you think like that nowadays?
Parce que le principe, en principe, vous ne devez pas réagir.
Because in principle, you're quand not y a supposed un événement, to react when something happens.
Vous ne pouvez pas sentir, ressentir la joie
you're
ou
not supposed to feel
le regret.
Joy or regret.
Essayez d'analyser froidement
try and analyze the event
l'événement
coldly.
Ce qui est négatif, ce qui est positif pour le mouvement.
Find what is negative, what is positive for the movement, and then try to take the right actions.
Je le vois constamment ici au Cardamom.
I can see him all the time in the Cardamom Mountains. Here
mais
and
c'est
there.
L'homme, ça, j'ai son image.
I have his image in my head.
Il vous manquait, Pol Pot.
Do you miss Pol Pot?
Parce que c'est une tête rare, quand même.
He was such an exceptional thinker.
And I think the AV booth, that was the last segment which I wanted to show
merci
this morning, Your Honours. And I will take 1 minute to briefly bring together the factual matters which we submit are apparent from the materials we presented yesterday and today. In our submission, these documents show a long-standing relationship between Khieu Samphan and other key leaders of the communist movement. They contradict his claims in our submission that he was a minister of defense of nothing,
a
claim he made at the beginning of this segment.
Le ministre de la Défense de
again,
rien
in our submission and recalling the documents, the public appeals that we quoted from yesterday, they evidence his contemporaneous knowledge of the situation on the battlefield, of crimes being committed by Khmer Rouge troops. In fact, in our submission, they indicate his endorsement of that brutality. There was also a reference by Khieu Samphan in one of the interviews to his knowledge of meetings prior to the evacuation of Phnom Penh. The New York Times article includes an apparent admission that he participated in a decision to evacuate Phnom Penh, which, again, that article indicates was a collective decision. The materials also, and in particular the 2004 book, contain extensive commentary by Khieu Samphan on the policies of enforced collectivization and use of armed militia to execute enemies. Of course, I'm paraphrasing his words, but they do appear in all of the segments we quoted from yesterday. Lastly, two matters. In this video, we saw Khieu Samphan indicate that he accepted the use of violence to achieve political aims in 1970. And lastly, the documents which my colleague referred to yesterday indicate that he presided over a Congress which reached a resolution to execute the seven traitors as they were referred to by the leadership of the Khmer Rouge. This concludes our presentation of relevant documents for Mr. Khieu Samphan. And with your Honour's leave, I will now hand the floor to my colleagues who will deal with documents relating to Yang Sari.
Thank you. Relatifs à Yang Sari. Merci. Le président.
The President, please proceed.
Good morning, Mr. President. Good morning, Your Honours. Good morning, everyone.
Bonjour, Monsieur le Président, Madame,
on behalf of the prosecution, I would like to move to the document relating to Yang Sari.
Documents qui concernent Yang Sari.
Now the prosecution moves to the third part of its document presentation.
Il s'agit de la troisième partie de relating notre présentation to de documents.
Documents that are particularly relevant in proving facts alleged in the historical background section of the indictment.
La partie contexte historique de l'acte d'accusation.
We submit that this next group of documents
selon
will particularly assist in proving Yang Sari's association with, participation in, and knowledge of the revolutionary movement in Cambodia prior to and through the formation and activities of the Communist Party of Kambodia until the 17th of April 1975,
when the party gained control over the entire country.
The documents selected to demonstrate this today are written records of interviews, either verbatim or in summary form, which Yang Sari himself has given about his role and participation in the CPK's rise to power from the 1940s until the 17th of April 1975. These interviews provide a voice to the accused who, in his own words, explains the history and structure of the CPK, his knowledge of its ideological underpinnings and policies, his association in formulating that ideology, his association with its functional organizations and other leaders, plus his active participation in the endorsement and implementation of those policies.
Et de sa participation active à la mise en œuvre et à l'élaboration de ces politiques.
បទសម្ភាសន៍មួយចំនួនរបស់អៀងសេរីដែលបានផ្ដល់នៅដើមទសវត្សរ៍ឆ្នាំ1970ដែលនៅត្រូវដាក់បង្ហាញគឺសុទ្ធតែមានលក្ខណៈបង្ខិតបង្ខំទាំងអស់ដោយហេតុថាបានធ្វើឡើងក្នុងគណៈដែលមានកើនឡើងនូវចំនួនប្រដាប់អាវុធរវាងបកកុម្មុយនីសកម្ពុជានិងលន់នល់.
A few of Yang Sari's interviews given in the early 1970s to be presented are all the more compelling as they were made while the armed conflict between the CPK and the Lon Nol was occurring. These interviews and ones made later during the late 70s by Yang Sari provide candid accounts from the accused untouched by revisionism that can occur later in the face of international criticism of the policies implemented by the CPK and consequential impending criminal prosecution for the crimes committed in the DK
period. L'époque et du critique international des politiques du PCK.
Other documents from Yang Sari's co-accused and other contemporaneous documents made at the time of the CPK's rise to power will also be highlighted as they provide primary probative evidence of his pre-1975 political and administrative activities that aided the CPK's full takeover of Cambodia on the 17th of April 1975. As we have submitted before this chamber, documents produced contemporaneously to the events on trial can be highly probative in proving those events as the details are often comprehensive and recorded whilst the events are fresh in the author's memory.
peuvent avoir une forte valeur probante pour étayer ces événements, comme alors que les détails
and
sont
in many cases not affected by manipulation at a later date when those events are required to be recounted again for particular purposes such as trial.
Dans plusieurs cas, n'ont pas été affectés par la manipulation.
Your Honours, to provide an overview of the presentation, it will be presented in three segments. First, I will highlight the particular relevance of the agreed facts document provided by INSARI, and then I will guide Your Honours through one of the many interviews given by INSARI relating to the pre-1975 history, structure, policies and activities of the CPK and INSARI's role in them.
Ou plutôt au travers d'une des nombreuses interviews données par Yeng Sari
My
sur
colleague,
la question
Mr.
de
William
l'histoire
Smith
de la structure
will
des politiques d'avant 1975 ainsi que des activités du PCK et le rôle de Yeng Sari dans ces derniers.
Are further elaborated
Mon confrère
soulignera
par la suite d'autres interviews données par Yeng Sari
And to finish,
dans lesquelles il
we will
élabore
indicate
sur ces
to
sujets.
Your honors documents that provide evidence of the extent of INSARI's activities from 1970 to 1975, where much of his time was spent in Beijing, representing the Communist Party of Kampuchea and actively seeking support for its goals.
À obtenir un soutien pour les objectifs du parti.
I will now turn to the first document.
Permettez-moi d'abord
the document that has been agreed.
Document
number
E9/21.3,
dated the 25th of March 2011.
En date du 25 mars 2011.
A relevant page in English, EAN 00665. Again, E00656964 to E00656981. Which is the list of agreed facts provided by INSARI in this trial.
Fournis par l'équipe de défense de Yeng Sari dans ce procès.
Of course, I will not reread these facts as that was done last week in court. However, I would like to briefly highlight to the Chamber the document's particular relevance and importance in proving the historical background section of the indictment and the pre-1975 section relating to the role of INSARI in the communist revolution and the CPK.
D'avant 1975 portant sur le rôle de Yeng Sari dans la révolution communiste et le PCK.
Yeng Sari's and other accused role and activities prior to 1975 is a significant issue to be decided in this case in order to assist you in determining the accused responsibility for crimes charged in the first trial.
Plutôt est une question qu'il faudra trancher dans ce procès pour vous aider à déterminer la responsabilité des accusés pour les crimes sur l'acte d'accusation.
Consequently, I would like to draw your attention to the relevance of these agreed facts.
J'aimerais donc maintenant porter l'attention de la Chambre sur la pertinence de ces faits non litigieux.
Your Honours, through his agreed facts, Yeng Sari traced the defining moments in the development of the CPK leading up to 1975.
It was at the first party congress
held on the 30th of September 1960 in Phnom Penh, that the Khmer People's Revolutionary Party
became the Workers' Party of Cambodia, a crucial moment in the Communist Party of Cambodia history, which Ieng Sary confirms was the real starting point of the Cambodian Communist movement. The agreed facts show that Ieng Sary was at the heart of the movement from the very beginning.
Already a member of the Central Committee,
he was made a full rights member of the Standing Committee.
Et devenu membre de plein
the President, Mr. Ieng Sary, Defense Counsel, is
le
on his feet. You may proceed.
La parole est à la défense de Ieng Sary.
Good morning, Your Honors, and good morning to everyone in and around the courtroom. For the last 15 minutes, we haven't heard a single document being presented by the gentleman. This is another opening statement. They had an opportunity to give an opening statement. They will have an opportunity to give a closing argument. But as far as I understand, the purpose of the next day or two is not for the prosecutors to get up and make speeches. Now, if he wishes to point to a document, fine. He read what he read last week. I do not object, we agree to those facts. But now he's simply making speeches. It's a waste of our time.
Mais là, il s'agit either they pose documents or he should sit down. D'une perte de temps. Soit il présente des documents, soit il se rassoit.
The President, the International Co-Prosecutor, you may respond.
Good morning, Mr. President. Good morning, Council. Good morning, the public. Firstly, in relation to the attitude of the Defence Council, we would submit that telling Council to sit down in that method is not appropriate behaviour in this courtroom.
But
addressing his objection in substance, Your Honours have said yesterday that the prosecution was able to present documents and explain and highlight the relevance and the critical importance of them in this case. As Your Honours are aware, the agreed facts document was a document that was provided by the defence to the prosecution, which was filed to the court. My friend is correct, last Thursday, my learned friend read out those agreed facts. However, in terms of reading out the agreed facts, that's similar to what was discussed yesterday, reading out any document without stating the relevance of that document to this case.
So
we would ask, and this submission in relation to agreed facts would take about another 10 minutes, we would ask that my national colleague be allowed to explain the relevance
nous
of those agreed facts to proving aspects in this case. And particularly, we're talking about the forced transfer from Phnom Penh and other towns and cities in 1975. The facts themselves, Your Honours, does not spell that out. The prosecution will not be taking up a great length of time to do that, probably 10 minutes or so. The relevance would be addressed at each step of the way. But, Your Honours, we feel that the purpose of this hearing is to demonstrate to the public the relevance of evidence in brief form. We would like the opportunity to do that, because certainly the documents in relation to Ieng Sary need to be looked at in light of those agreed facts. So if Your Honour permits, we would like to do that for about another 5 or so minutes and then move on to the interview which my friend had talked about.
We don't intend to dwell. Puis de passer à la présentation des documents, nous n'allons pas nous attarder sur le sujet.
The defense counsel for Ieng Sary, you may
La parole est à la défense de Ieng Sary.
The prosecution drafted an introductory submission. After that, you had an investigative judge or judges go through the
and
finally we're here.
Puis, les co-juges d'instruction,
the public is well aware.
Ici,
last week, they read out the agreed facts.
L'accusation
they had an opportunity last week to go ahead and make any commentary. For the last 15 minutes, we heard commentary. What the international prosecutor is suggesting is that they make another opening statement or closing argument. This is not the purpose of the hearing.
Ce n'est pas l'objectif
now, if
de
they wish to present documents and read those documents, we have no objections. But we do object to the prosecution using these hearings as a form of lobbying their case by making speeches. They can present evidence. That's what a trial is about. Otherwise, we should simply sit down and just listen to the prosecutor, sinon, give their closing argument, and you can just deliberate. There's no reason to go forward with any more evidence. They're simply giving speeches. And as I understand it, that's not the purpose of the hearing, not to give speeches. The agreed facts speak for themselves. Now, they can present their evidence, or, as I suggested, they should move on. Thank you.
The President.
Le Président.
Thank you for the observation made by the Defense Council for Yeng Sari.
La Chambre remercie les partis pour leurs observations.
On the parameter for
la défense de Yeng Sari pour avoir
the presentation of document
rappeler les paramètres
made by the representative for prosecution.
Et la présentation de l'accusation.
The chamber notes that the presentation by
la
the prosecution
rappelle que, ou note plutôt que la présentation des procureurs
rather broad,
ratisse un peu large,
it almost amounts to the
fait valoir
pleading
qu'il s'agit
already.
Presque d'une plaidoirie.
And the chamber wishes to remind the party that the purpose of today's hearing is to indicate a document that is of significant importance to the public and
quels
documents parties,
sont de pertinence
and it also provides the opportunity
important.
For parties to present documents before the chamber.
Il laisse aux parties
and to
la
ensure greater measure of public accessibility to the document, to the documentary aspect of the trial, and it also
pour
provides
plus accessible l'aspect de preuve documentaire du procès.
Key document considered to be particularly important to the historical background segment of case 0
que les parties jugent particulièrement important pour
slash 01. So,
context historique du dossier
this is not the opportunity for party to make any pleading.
Mais il ne s'agit pas d'une occasion de faire des plaidoiries. La Chambre espère donc que les parties comprennent bien l'objectif.
So the prosecution may now proceed.
Et la parole est maintenant à l'accusation.
Thank you, Mr. President. I would like to now proceed to the second document.
Je vous remercie, Monsieur le Président. Je vais maintenant passer
on the
deuxième
Yeng Sari interview by with Mr. Dan Burstein.
Il s'agit
this interview
d'une interview
was conducted
de Yeng Sari avec
sometime
Dan
in April
Burstein.
1978.
C'est une interview qui s'était faite en avril 1978.
A key document in this regard is a summarized written records of an interview
le
with
document particulièrement
Yeng Sari
pertinent
conducted by Mr. Daniel
Burstein
in April 1978.
De l'interview de Yeng Sari faite par Daniel Burstein en avril 1978.
The case file is
que l'on retrouve
the case file number is
aux ORN suivants.
D366/7.1.4642 with relevant English EON
0S00042 to S00493S00028
and Khmer EON S00728116 to S00728150 and French EON S00742540 to S00742558. This interview is contained in a book entitled Cambodia Today.
On retrouve cette interview dans un ouvrage dont le titre est
An Eyewitness
le Cambodia
Report
d'aujourd'hui.
From Cambodia. Published in 1978
son titre en anglais était Cambodia Today, an Eyewitness Report from Cambodia, publié en 1978 par Carl
Illinois,
Pamphlets à Chicago en Illinois,
of the United States,
aux États-Unis d'Amérique.
The introduction states that the book is a report of the very first Americans to visit Democratic Cambodia since the liberation of the country in April 1975.
It states
the Americans who made the visit were journalists of the core newspaper led by editor Daniel Burstein
ou Le Clairon, dont Daniel Burstein était le rédacteur en
chef. The editor states that they spent a week in April 1978.
Affirme qu'ils ont passé une semaine en avril 1978 et ont voyagé sur plus de 700 provinces dans six provinces du Cambodge.
Of the Communist Party of Cambodia.
Parti communiste du Cambodia.
As for the particular interview recorded with Ieng Sary, chapter 8 of the book provides
l'interview
a first-hand account in
Ieng
three
Sary
parts
au chapitre 8 de cet ouvrage,
by Ieng Sary of part 1, the history of the revolutionary movement in Cambodia
en trois parties
that
par
led
Ieng Sary
up
de
to the founding of the Communist
au Cambodge
Party
qui a mené
in
à la fondation
1960.
Du Parti communiste dans les années 60.
Part 2, the party's activities
sont les
from 1960 to the military coup d'état
jusqu'au moment du coup d'état militaire de 1970.
And part 3, the party's
partie,
activities through the war with
état, des
government
du parti
forces
la guerre,
until
avec
the 17th
du gouvernement,
of April
1975.
By way of introduction to the interview, Dean Burstein calls his interview with the accused as the high point of his visit to Cambodia.
Dan Burstein,
he
characterizes Ieng Sary
as warm and joyful in manner.
Il décrit Ieng Sary comme quelqu'un
and
de chaleureux et de
that
jovial.
He told the history, the story of the Cambodia Revolution, step by step,
qu'il lui a raconté
point
l'histoire de la révolution du Cambodia,
the
étape par étape,
stretching on until midnight.
Et que l'interview a duré jusqu'à minuit.
Mr. Burstein described how Ieng Sary had arrived to his current position as Deputy Prime Minister in charge of foreign affairs.
À son poste actuel de vice-premier ministre chargé des affaires étrangères.
Now 48 years old,
aujourd'hui âgé de 48
Sary
ans,
was one of the founders of the
Sary
Communist Party of Cambodia
est un des
and had
du
been
Parti communiste du
a guerrilla fighter in the countryside between 1963 and 1970.
Dans la campagne cambodgienne de 1963-1970.
From 1970 until the victory of the revolution in 1975, he had traveled the world as a special envoy of the United Front government fighting to win support for Cambodia's liberation war in the international arena.
Et se battait pour obtenir le soutien pour la guerre de libération du Cambodia sur la scène internationale.
With your leave, I would like to present the first part.
La première
in the first part of the interview, Ieng Sary began with an overview of the fight against the French colonial
donc dans cette première
colonialists
partie de l'interview, Ieng Sary doit faire un survol de la lutte contre les colons
Mr. Burstein paraphrases Ieng Sary as saying that revolutionary organizations of Cambodian people waged armed struggle as early as 1947. But that no Marxist Leninist leadership existed at the time.
Mais qu'à l'époque,
Mr. Burstein quotes Ieng Sary
de leadership Marxist
with
Leninist
the
à
relevant
Ieng Sary
English EON page S000.
C'est donc Ieng Sary
493
à la page S0094322 en anglais.
Quote,
je cite,
the main task at this stage was to win our national independence from France, end quote.
La tâche Ieng Sary principale à cette époque-là était de remporter ou d'arracher notre indépendance nationale à la France.
Anti-imperialist
a souligné
and
les contradictions qui existaient entre les anti-impérialistes cambodgiens et les vietnamiens, expliquant, et je cite,
Vietnam trained
que le Vietnam
its
a formé ses cadres
at this time,
à ce moment-là,
in the belief that the three countries of Indochina were really all one country and should have only one party.
Pays d'Indochine devaient être en fait un seul pays. on ne devrait avoir qu'un seul parti. Nous n'étions pas d'accord.
Bustin summarizes some Ying Sari's comments regarding development in the fight against the French through the 1950s, noting that many leaders began to study
ont commencé à étudier la pensée marxiste-léniniste Mao Tse-tung
and that there were an ideological struggle regarding the questions of whether to engage in armed struggle to establish
sur la question de savoir s'il fallait lancer une lutte armée pour créer un système socialiste.
Ying Sari pointed to the betrayal of the revolutionary movement by one of its leaders in 1958 as a turning point, saying,
moment fort du mouvement révolutionnaire était une trahison par un de ses dirigeants de 1958.
English EON S00 4932, after this betrayal,
après cette trahison,
we knew we had to become more self-reliant, deepen our understanding of Marxism-Leninism, Mao Zedong, sought and found a communist party of our own to organize and lead the struggle.
Hey. Fin de la citation.
The growing number of communists began to develop a political program.
Ying Sari
a expliqué que un grand nombre de communistes ont commencé à élaborer un programme politique,
à réaliser une analyse des classes de la société cambodgienne et organiser un parti.
He said, and I quote,
il a dit, je cite la page en anglais, S00 S00 4 93 22.
The repression was very
intense
at that time. We had very little experience.
Nous avions peu d'expérience.
We had not money.
Nous n'avions pas d'argent.
We went to the Soviet embassy secretly in Phnom Penh.
Nous sommes rendus secrètement à l'ambassade soviétique à Phnom Penh pour demander un emprunt de 10 000 riels,
about 160 US dollars, to start publishing a newspaper,
en vue de commencer à publier un journal.
But the Soviet ambassador attacked us.
Mais l'ambassadeur soviétique s'en est pris à nous.
We were ultra-leftists.
Il nous a dit que nous étions des ultra-gauchistes.
Could lead the revolution.
Pouvait mener la révolution.
He told us to never
il nous
come
a
back.
Dit de ne jamais revenir.
End of quote.
Fin de la citation.
Ying Sari continued. English EON
S00 4 93 23.
We expected to hold the founding congress in
1959.
The repression was so severe.
Toutefois, la répression était tellement sévère.
However,
que cela
that this proved impossible. We left our houses
chaque matin,
every day in the morning,
nous
not knowing if we would return home alive
si
in the evening.
Vivant le soir.
Finally, in 1960,
we were able to gather all the representatives
together to found the party. We met for 3 days from September 28th to the 30th in an abandoned railway building here in Phnom Penh. Our security had to be very tight.
Nous étions très stricts
no
sur le
one
plan
could
de la
come in
Personne
or go out during the meeting.
Entrer ou sortir pendant toute la durée de
Mr.
la réunion.
Bustin notes.
Fin de citation.
Ying Sari indicated the Congress succeeded in founding the party,
il apparaît
adopting
également
a constitution and electing a central committee, quoting Ying Sari to say, English EON
S00 04 93 23. ERN anglais S00049323.
Stand on the absolute necessity of the armed struggle.
La bonne position par rapport à l'absolue
but we still had much ideological
mais
work to do on this question.
Idéologique à réaliser sur ce point.
We had to educate the party members that the reform struggles for land, democratic rights, better living standards, etc., were very important.
Des meilleures conditions
but
de vie, etc.,
they could not
cela
give us
ne suffirait pas à nous donner le pouvoir.
Only the armed struggle led by the party could put political power in our hands.
Pouvoir politique entre nos mains.
However, by 1963, the CPK leaders
cependant,
had to leave
en 1963, les dirigeants du PCK
due to the political repression
face à la répression
and
politique
the growing
qui s'abattait sur
power of the
right-wing. Croissant de l'aile droitière
Mr. Bostein
de l'Union.
Quotes Inzeri regarding the moment
Bostein
of the CPK's leaders.
Lorsqu'il évoque
English
les mouvements
E-O-N
des dirigeants du PCK, c'est le RN anglais.
00049323. Je cite. We left
Phnom Penh
and went to the northeast countryside in the province of Ratanakiri.
De Ratanakiri.
That concludes part one
j'en
of Mr. Bostein's with Ying Sari. I would like now to proceed to part two
de
concerning the interviews
de avec
with
Ying Sari.
In the second
je
part of the interview, Bostein states that Ying Sari indicated that
Ying
in Sari February 1963,
février 1963,
the CPK secretary was assassinated,
avait été
and that an emergency second congress was held in which Pol Pot was elected party secretary.
Pol Pot a été élu secrétaire du parti.
Quoting Ying Sari, English
je cite,
after the second congress,
après le deuxième congrès,
we began to build
nous avons
up our forces in the countryside slowly and patiently. We did a great deal of education
nous
among the cadres about the importance of serving the people, being self-sacrificing, and maintaining discipline at all times. The communist education helped carry the party members through very difficult times later on. Ying Sari describes his experiences at that time, and I quote English S00049323.
9, 3, 2,
3. We were living in the forest and had no real food to supply. We relied on the local tribesmen who were minority nationalities and very tough fighters to bring us food from the villages. Sometimes they would be captured by the enemy. Though, and then we would have no food at all. We would have to live on bamboo that grew in the forest for a week or more at a time. But we always remained confident. We knew these tribesmen would never betray us. Even under torture, they would tell the reactionaries nothing about our bases. English ERN S00049323. We also had a large united front movement, but it took no organizational form. We just spread the ideas of uniting the people to fight for an independent, neutral, and non-aligned Cambodia. With these slogans, we could unite with various forces among the petty bourgeoisie, the intellectuals, the administration officials, and the national capitalists. Bostein notes that Ieng Sary described the three groups with the Cambodian ruling class at that time,
les trois groupes
with Lon Nol on the far right, Sihanouk and others who opposed communism in the center, and progressive people like Khieu Samphan on the left. Bostein quotes Ieng Sary on how the CPK approached different groups.
Parle de la manière dont le PCK voyait les différents groupes. Je vais citer le RN anglais S0004-9323.
We mobilized both the middle and left sections of the ruling class and built a united front with them against foreign domination. We isolated the real traitors like Lon Nol. Mr. Bostein notes that Ieng Sary stressed that the CPK believed that the fundamental force in the United Front had to be the workers, the peasants, quoting Ieng Sary, English E-R-N-English, S0004-9323-S0049324. Although our party was secret,
je cite, bien que notre parti était tenu secret,
the people knew that there was a Khmer Rouge movement.
Existait un mouvement Khmer Rouge.
The people knew our party was fighting for land,
parti se battait pour les terres,
democratic rights,
pour les droits démocratiques,
and a better standard of living.
Niveau de vie.
We educated the masses step by step about the role of the armed struggle, even though we had not yet established an army. The party established clandestine guards or units of peasants that secretly infiltrated the government's militia. Regarding these units, Ieng Sary is quoted
with a
right smile, English ERN S0004-9324. When the landlords ordered these militia forces to attack the people, our men would refuse.
Je cite.
The clandestine guards played an important role in defending our cadres and leaders and allowing our base areas to develop. Mr. Bostein summarizes Ieng Sary regarding the occurrence of peasant rebellions and the reaction of Lon Nol, describing a 1967 peasant rebellion in Somlod in the northwest, where the CPK supported the peasants and led to the massacre of communist and progressive forces by Lon Nol in reaction. Regarding these developments, Ieng Sary stated, I quote,
à ce sujet,
English
Ieng Sary a indiqué ce qui suit. S0004-9324.
From June of 1967 on, the party began to lay plans to organize an army.
Le parti a commencé à dresser des plans pour une armée.
Lon Nol would eventually try to stage a coup d'état. And we had to get prepared for that situation. Mr. Yingsari told Mr. Borstein about how the Revolutionary Army battled on January the 17th
by Dambram near Battambang,
capturing their first weapons.
Yingsari is quoted
regarding the state of the Revolutionary Army,
English E-A-N-S. L'état 0, de l'armée révolutionnaire. 0, 0, 4, il s'agit de l'ERN 9, 3, anglais 9324.
On February 25th,
le 25 février,
the Central Committee issued a circular calling for insurrections all over the country. Even though it was a very difficult situation for us, with hardly any weapons, no doctors, and no medicine, we knew that our line was correct. And so, we were able to inspire the people to fight. Mr. Borstein provides that Yingsari recognized Sihanouk as a potential ally,
and so the CPK Sihanouk and the Revolutionary Army
made clear they were fighting the right-wing
et
militarists and
que le PCK et
not
l'armée révolutionnaire
Sihanouk.
Faisait savoir clairement
Yingsari describes an attack by Lonno's government forces. I quote,
Sari a décrit une attaque menée par les forces de l'ONOL.
Je cite le RN anglais S0004-9324. It was not just 10,000 troops they sent against us, but also armored cars,
ce ne sont pas seulement 10 000 troupes qu'ils ont envoyées contre nous,
and
mais également des véhicules armés,
artillery,
des avions et de l'artillerie.
Even with all this firepower, they couldn't knock us out.
Réussi à nous écraser.
Winning this battle
remporter
gave us
bataille a renforcé
great
notre
confidence.
Confiance en nous. Fin de citation.
However, as Yingsari is paraphrased to say, English E-R-N S-0004,
9324.
By the end of 1969, it was becoming obvious that
Sihanouk's
neutralist stance could not be tolerated much longer by the U.S. imperialists, who were seeking to use Cambodia as a base for attack against Vietnam. Lon Nol, on the other hand, was
D'autre
perfectly
part,
willing to let the U.S. use Cambodia as a staging area against Vietnam, that
Lon Nol
would come to power
pour le PCK,
in coup d'état
il était couru
was
d'avance
for the CPK
a
foregone
à la faveur
conclusion.
D'un coup d'état.
Mr. Borstein sets the stage for the third part of the interview.
Ensuite,
our interview Borstein with Yingsari had already lasted well into the evening when he began to talk of the events following the U.S. instigated coup d'état that put Lon Nol in power on March
de
the 18th, 1970.
En mars 1970, le 18,
English
avec l'appui des Américains, Borstein cite Yingsari, c'est le RN S0004-9324-9325.
March the 18th, 1970 to April the 17th of 1975 was the period of our open war against U.S. aggression and the Lon Nol traitor clique. We relied on our own forces to fight this war, capturing 80% of the arms that our guerrilla fighters used. China also gave us great support. Mr. Bostein says that Yang Sari described in lively detail battle after battle fought by the Revolutionary Army and its growing strength. He told of how the CPK established revolutionary political power of the workers and peasants in the liberated zones, and how the people rallied to the side
of the travailleurs et des paysans dans les zones libérées, et comment le peuple s'est rallié à la cause du parti à travers tout le pays.
Yang Sari is quoted to say,
ensuite,
English
Bernstein
E-R-N-S
cite Yang Sari.
Joined the United Front of the CPK in establishing
Grung in Peking.
Yang Sari continues, ERN-E-S-0004-9325. The people bitterly hated Lon Nol. The broad masses were ready to fight. They rallied to our party, our army, and the United Front, because they saw that we were in the forefront of the struggle against Lon Nol. Yang Sari noted that as the Revolutionary Army liberated more territory, the U.S. intensified its pressure on Cambodia, English ERN-S-0004-9325. From January 27th to August 15, 1973, the imperialists mobilized all their forces against us. There was a ceasefire in Vietnam and Laos, so the American bombers were turned against us. In the liberated zones, Yang Sari described the CPK's establishment of cooperatives,
English ERN-S-0004-9325.
The building of the cooperative system in 1973 was a vital strategic question for our revolution. Without the cooperatives, the young men could not have been able to go fight at the front, assured that their families would be well cared for. Without the cooperatives, the price of rice would have suffered a terrible inflation and our troops would have had little to eat. But thanks to the cooperative system, we were better able to mobilize the whole people to fight guerrilla war, to resist the bombings, to resist Lon Nol's offensives, and liberate more and more territory. Yang Sari also discussed some problems that arose at that time. English ERN-S-0004-9325. We weren't hungry ourselves.
Nous nous sommes so affamés pour que nos frères vietnamiens puissent manger notre
could have
riz.
Our rice. And yet they did not deliver the arms and equipment that were intended for us.
Yingsari
continued, our line was to uphold solidarity with Vietnam,
for raising political struggles and differences privately. Fin de citation.
Mr. Boston paraphrases Yingsari regarding the January 1975 Mekong River offensive, which culminated in the liberation of Phnom Penh on April 17, 1975. Towards the end of the document, Boston then quote Sari on the subject of Phnom Penh's liberation and the next steps in the work of the CPK. English ERN S 0004-9325. With the liberation of the whole country in April 1975, the National Democratic Revolution was achieved. Our victory was due to a correct analysis of the situation in our own country and confidence in the masses of people who proved to be the main fighting force. Yingsari goes on. English
poursuit à la page ERN anglais 004-9325-999. Je cite.
We did not rest
nous
for
ne nous
one
pas
minute.
Une seule minute.
We immediately
nous
set
nous
to work
immédiatement au travail
to defend
pour défendre le pays.
The country and to
et
build
créer
and
et
develop the socialist
système.
System. We established a dictatorship of the proletariat collectivized and rather the national wealth. We began to cultivate the collectivist spirit. However, Yingsari noted that certain problems persisted.
Je cite.
In 1975, we were immediately faced with grave threats to the security of the revolution, both in terms of attacks on our borders as well as from within our own ranks. The CIA, the KGB, the Vietnamese, and others were all intent on mobilizing their forces for a coup d'état against us.
Fin de citation.
Mr. President, Your Honors.
Monsieur le Président, Madame, Messieurs les Juges.
In my conclusion,
j'en viens à ma conclusion.
I have now finished discussing this document and will hand over to my colleague. And these interviews given by Yingsari and other documents which will provide more specific proof of relevant facts contained in the historical background section of the indictment and the pre-1975 role of Yingsari in this
preuves concernant les faits
history.
Mentionné dans la partie
I would like
contexte
now,
historique
indeed,
de l'acte d'accusation
like to hand over
et concernant
to my colleague,
le rôle
Williams,
de Yingsari durant la
the
période
president.
Antérieure à 1975. J'aimerais donner la parole à mon confrère,
for
le Président.
The chamber
le moment
would
est venu
take,
de marquer une pause
for 20 minutes.
The
next
minutes.
Session will be resumed at 10 to 11. We note Mr. Ang Adam
les
is on his feet.
Reprendront à 10h50.
You may proceed. Counsel Ang Adam,
Maître
thank you, Mr. President, Your
parole.
Honors.
La défense.
Due to
merci.
Health concern of my client, he has experienced some pain in one of his feet.
A mal au pied.
He therefore asked that he be excused from this courtroom and follow the proceeding from his holding cell,
depuis la cellule temporaire.
Therefore, allow the president.
Le président.
We note the request made by Yeng Sari through his counsel,
présentée par Yeng Sari par le biais de son avocat,
that he be excused from this courtroom and follow the proceeding from the holding cell. Due to the fact that he cannot remain sitting for long,
l'accusé the chamber affirme grants ne pas such pouvoir request. Rester assis trop longtemps. La chambre fait droit à cette requête.
And the chamber allows Yeng Sari to Yeng Sari follow proceedings
est donc autorisé à suivre l'audience
from his holding cell
depuis
for
la cellule temporaire.
Hearing. However, counsels for Yeng Sari
are
advised to produce
l'avocat de Yeng Sari
the waiver
est invité à remettre à la chambre le document de renonciation portant la signature
or given some print by him.
Ou les empreintes digitales de Yeng Sari.
AV officers are now instructed to connect
les services
the
techniques
AV or aid audiovisual equipment
le matériel
to
audiovisuel
the holding cell
fonctionne.
And security personnel are now instructed
de sécurité,
to bring Yeng Sari to the holding cell where AV equipment is already set up. The court is adjourned.